the previous class, we have studied about the metallic conduction and electroconduction, the differences between metallic and electrolytic conduction. We have also studied what is specific conductance, equivalent conductance, and molar conductance. Today, the next topic we are going to discuss is variation of specific and equivalent conductance with dilution. How specific conductance and equivalent conductance varies with or changes with dilution. When more and more water is added to an electrolyte, what happens to the specific and equivalent conductance? Listen, in the last class we have studied specific conductance. The specific conductance is the conductance of a solution, that is the conductance of a the conductance of all the ions present in 1 cm³ of a solution. Okay, that is when we take 1 cm³, this is 1 cm³, it contains many number of ions, okay, 1 cc. So this is specific conductance. Is the conductance of all the ions present in 1 cm³ of a solution. Then what happens when water is added to it? More and more water. Okay, if I take an electrolytic solution, okay, it contains different ions moving here and there on dilution. Okay, on dilution. What happens? The volume of the solution increases. The volume of an electrolyte increases. As a result, what happens? The amount of ions available in 1 cm³ of a solution naturally decreases. Therefore, the specific conductance decreases with increase in dilution. See, we get that is the specific conductance decreases with dilution. Why? Because as the dilution increases, the number of ions in 1 cm³ of the solution decreases. Therefore, the specific conductance of a given electrolyte decreases with increase in dilution. As the concentration is lesser and lesser, when dilution is become greater, automatically what happens? The specific conductance decreases with increase in dilution or with increase in or with decrease in concentration. The next topic, equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance, yesterday we have studied the formula lambda C is equal to 1000 into kappa divided by C. See, this is the concentration. When dilution increases, what happens? The concentration of the solution decreases. When the concentration decreases, equivalent conductance increases. See, by the addition of more and more water, as the dilution increases, the equivalent conductance increases. This is because of increase in the degree of dissociation of an electrolyte. Particularly, this is in the case of weak electrolyte. But in the case of strong electrolyte, the degree of dissociation is constant at all concentration. Anyhow, with increase in dilution, even in the case of strong electrolyte, the ions will lie very far apart with one another. There will be very less intra-ionic forces of attraction. Therefore, the mobility of the ions will be very much high. Therefore, the equivalent conductance increases with increase in dilution. What is degree of dissociation? Degree of dissociation is the fraction of the total electrolyte that exists in the form of ions in the solution is called degree of dissociation. In the case of weak electrolytes, also the equivalent conductance increases with increase in dilution is due to increase in the degree of ionization or degree of dissociation. Okay, you know already that degree of dissociation alpha equal to lambda c divided by lambda infinity. Lambda c is the equivalent conductance at a given concentration. This is equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Okay, as the dilution increases, the degree of dissociation increases, therefore the equivalent conductance of an electrolyte also increases. For example, it can be easily explained by taking the graph. Equivalent conductance is plotted against the concentration, root of concentration. That is, for many number of strong electrolytes like NaCl, KCl, okay, this is HCl, etc., the equivalent conductance goes on increases with a decrease in the concentration. At zero concentration, that is at the lambda zero, that is at zero concentration, after extrapolation, we can find out the lambda zero values. Equivalent conductance at zero concentration or at infinite dilution, it is maximum in the case of strong electrolytes. But in the case of weak electrolytes, okay, in the case of acetic acid, what happens? Here also equivalent conductance increases, but it does not attain the limiting value, but this goes parallel to the y-axis. So we are not able to find out the exact value of equivalent conductance at infinite dilution of weak electrolyte. That is why we are using Kolbach law. By using the Kolbach law, we can find out the lambda zero value of weak electrolyte. But in the case of strong electrolyte, we can easily find out by extrapolation technique. So remember, equivalent conductance increases with increase in dilution due to increase in the degree of ionization. Even though equivalent conductance increases, but the specific conductance decreases. The specific conductance decreases with increase in dilution, whereas equivalent conductance increases with increase in dilution due to increase in the degree of ionization or due to increase in the mobility of the ions in the case of strong electrolytes. Okay, this is about the variation of equivalent conductance and specific conductance with dilution. The next very important topic we are going to study is transport number and its determination by Itov's method. What is meant by transport number? Transport number is usually represented by T. For cation, it is represented as T plus, and the transport number of anion is represented as T minus. What is actually transport number? Transport number is nothing but the fraction of the total current carried by ion is called its transport number. Okay? For a given solution, the transport number of cation and transport number of anion is always unity. Okay? See, the fraction of the total current carried by each ion is called transport number. For example, the transport number of cation is nothing but current carried by cation divided by total current. In a similar manner, we can write the transport number of anion. T minus transport number of anion can be written as current carried by anion divided by total current. Now let us consider, I can write the transport number of cation will be equal to current carried by cation divided by total current, that is nothing but it is a sum of current carried by cation and current carried by anion. This U actually shows mobility, because the current carrying capacity mainly depends on the mobility of the ions. Greater the mobility, greater the current carrying capacity, greater will be the conductance. So U plus shows the mobility of cation. The mobility of cation and mobility of anion put together gives the total current. Similarly, we can also write transport number of anion will be equal to current carried by anion divided by total current. Okay, this is the transport number. So the definition of transport number is the fraction of the total current carried by each ion is called its transport number. For a given electrolyte, remember, for a given electrolyte, because most all the electrolytes are electrically neutral, the transport number of cation and transport number of anion for any given electrolyte, its value is always equal to 1. Once you know the value of transport number of cation, the transport number of anion can easily be calculated, and vice versa. If you know the value of transport number of anion, you can calculate the transport number of cation. For example, T plus is equal to 1 minus T minus. Similarly, T minus is equal to 1 minus T plus. So, if one transport number of one ion is known, the transport number of other ion can easily be calculated by using this following expression. Now, we are going to study how to find out the transport number by Kirchhoff's method. Very simple and easy method. For this, we have to draw the diagram. This is copper coulombitas. This is anodic compartment.
This is cathodic compartment. This is middle compartment. This is milliammeter. This is cathode. This is anode. This is the Abel test we are using to find out the transport number. It consists of, this electrode consists of a glass tube. It has two glass tubes at the two ends, and there is a middle compartment. In the middle compartment, there will be no change in the composition or in the concentration of the solution. Cathodic compartment is the left hand side, in the right hand side anodic compartment. Cathodic compartment is connected to the battery, okay, through a variable resistance. Anodic compartment is connected to the copper polarimeter through a milliammeter. Now, using this Kirchhoff's theoretical device, this is a device, we are going to find out the transport number of silver nitrate. Okay? Suppose here usually after electrolysis and before electrolysis we are going to find out the change in the concentration of an electrolyte around anode and cathode. Okay? Around anode and cathode, from the change in the weight, automatically when the concentration changes, density changes, volume changes, and thereby weight also changes. From the change or the decrease in the weight of an electrolyte, we are finding out the transport number of silver nitrate, that is Ag plus ions in the silver nitrate solution. This device is completely filled with silver nitrate, and cathode is made up of either platinum or silver electrode. To make an electrical contact, we are using a mercury in the bottom of a bulb. Okay, this is the device. Now, let us go to experimental section. How to find out the transport number of Ag plus ions? Listen. Now, let us consider, I am drawing. Suppose I am determining the transport number of Ag plus ions. Now I am taking, after electrolysis, we are supplying some 10 to 20 milliamperes of current for about 2 to 3 hours. Then after electrolysis, we are withdrawing the anodic compartment solution and finding out what is its weight change. Say, for example, if I take a gram of anodic compartment solution is found to contain b gram of silver nitrate, it has been calculated by titrating with standard potassium chloride solution. Okay? After electrolysis, a gram of anodic compartment solution is withdrawn and it is titrated with standard potassium chloride solution. It is found to contain b gram of silver nitrate. That means, what is the weight of water? Weight of water is a minus b gram. Okay? That means, a minus b gram of water contains b gram of silver nitrate or b by 170 gram equivalents of silver nitrate. B by 170 gram of silver nitrate. Say, a gram of anodic compartment after electrolysis is found to contain b gram of silver nitrate. Okay, the weight of water is a minus b. That means a minus b gram of water is associated with b gram of silver nitrate, or b by 170 gram of equivalent of silver nitrate. This value is found to be x. Sorry, y. This value is found to be y. Now, before electrolysis, okay, the calculation before electrolysis. Suppose C gram of silver nitrate solution, C gram of anodic compartment solution, okay, C gram of anodic compartment solution found to contain B gram of silver nitrate. That means, what is the weight of water associated? That is C minus B gram of water. Okay? C minus B gram of water associated with B gram of silver nitrate. That means, before electrolysis, listen, before electrolysis, A minus B gram of water would have been associated with B by C minus B into A minus B gram of silver nitrate. Okay? That is, A minus B gram of water before electrolysis would have been associated with B by C minus B into A minus B gram of silver nitrate, or A minus B divided by 170 gram equivalents of silver nitrate. Okay, gram equivalents of silver nitrate. This value is found to be x. Okay, then what is the fall of concentration? Okay, we may subtract the value of after electrolysis from before electrolysis. We can easily find out what is the change in concentration around anode to find out the transport number of Al plus ions. See, what is the fall of concentration? See, since the electrodes are not attackable by ions, if the electrodes are made up of platinum, then what is the fall of concentration around anode? The fall of concentration around anode equal to x minus y. Naturally, x will be, that is, y is lesser than x, x minus y. Now, not only that, a copper potentiometer is connected in series. Same amount of current is passing through the copper potentiometer. Copper potentiometer is nothing but a copper stick is immersed in a solution of copper sulfate. So what happens? Equivalent amount of copper will be deposited from the copper potentiometer. So therefore, the weight of copper deposited, weight of copper deposited in a potentiometer, because this value gives the amount of total current, coulombmeter is W, or W divided by 31.8 gram equivalent of copper. This you know according to Faraday's law. Okay? So therefore, this actually gives the value of total current passing through this device. Okay, then how will you find out this value is found to be Z? This value is found to be Z. Okay, that is W divided by 31.8 gram equivalent of copper that is deposited in a copper coulometer. It actually shows the amount of total current. Then we can easily find out the transport number of Ag plus ions will be equal to x minus y divided by z. Okay, this gives you the value of transport number of Ag plus ions. This is actually fall in the concentration around anode divided by total current. That is nothing but the current carried by, actually this value x minus y gives the current carried by Ag plus ions divided by total current, because the total current is passing through the copper coulometer which is connected in series. Okay, that is the amount of copper deposited in copper coulometer is x minus, that is z, and this x value is after electrolysis and y value is before electrolysis. So once you know the value of transport number of Ag plus ions, you can easily find out the transport number of nitrate ion NO3 minus ions, as I have given the equation T plus is equal to 1 minus T minus and T minus is equal to 1 minus T plus. So this method is very much useful in determining the transport number of Ag plus ions by Pitkov's method. It is a very important 5-mark question. You have to draw the diagram and explain all these calculations. Okay, the next topic we will study in the next class.